Hallo, Mirk.
Hello, teacher.
How are you today?
I'm fine, thank you.
Very good. Okay. Let me write quickly. Okay, I just want to write the time, then we can start. Can you see the paper?
Yes, I can.
Okay, let's have a look. We're going to go through it together. So our first unit is getting higher qualifications. Okay, just give me 1 minute. I just want to close the door. Okay. Okay, getting higher qualifications. I just want to translate it for you. Okay, getting higher qualifications. Okay, you understand?
Yes.
Okay, let's go and see. So, starting off, work in small groups. Explain what it means to have each of these personal qualities using your own words. Okay, when you're finished, look at page 9. Okay. Let me just turn this off. Hello, Van An. How are you today? I don't hear you. Okay, let's have a look, knock. Okay, A. You do things like reading documents very carefully and focus on all the small points, checking their accuracy. Okay, so that's for an I for detail. So you need to tell me for all of them, you need to give me a definition. Tell me what they all mean. Okay, if you don't understand, I will translate it for you and then you can explain to me, okay? Okay, so let's look at B. Can you read the word for me?
Creativity.
Yes, okay. Can you explain to me what creativity is?
I think creativity is things to the
Let me, I'm going to. So if you are creative, what does that mean?
I think creative activities is think more creatively, ideas that and good idea.
Okay, sometimes it's like doing art. Okay, you're creative, you come up with good ideas and good artwork. Oh, if you're creative, you can decorate well.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Van An, can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes, how are you today?
I'm five times.
Okay, good. Van An, can you read C for me? An inquiring mind.
In an oh, an inquiring mind.
Okay, I'm going to translate it, and then you can tell me what do you think a person with an inquiring mind does. Does that make sense to you?
Yes.
Okay, so what does that person do?
The person,
If they have an inquiring mind,
inquiring mind,
okay, if you are inquiring, you ask a lot of questions. Okay,
Okay.
so people who have an inquiring mind ask a lot of questions. They want to know a lot of things. Okay, they want to learn.
Learn of
Okay, okay. Knock D.
The abilities to work in team. It means that do something together with your friends or colleagues.
Yay, very good. Okay, you can work together with other people. Okay. Van An, E. Vision.
Vision.
Okay, if you have vision, it means you make goals for the future. Do you understand? Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So you like to make goals and you like to make projects so you can achieve them, but you're looking into the future. Okay, you can just repeat what I said, or you can tell me something else.
Reason means
You can make goals.
golf.
Goal, like people make goals.
Guess
Okay.
vision is mean you can make the goal for
Oh,
future.
yes, perfect. Very good. Okay. Now, if
An outgoing personality.
Let me put this off. An outgoing. If you are outgoing, it means you like to talk to people, you like to go places, you like to do things. Okay, if you are not outgoing, it means you stay at home and you don't talk to anybody.
An outgoing personality is the people like to go to another place and
And talk to people, they're not shy.
talk to people they know sight and discover many things.
Yes, okay, good. Okay, Van An, G.
Good community skill is mean you do anything to to protect the environment or something.
Communication means to talk. You're good at talking to people.
Yes.
Must I let me translate it for you. Good communication skills.
Yes.
Okay. So what does that mean?
Good communication skill mean is you can have a lot of communication skill to talk for some people talk to people.
Okay, so you're good at talking to people.
Yes.
Yes, okay. That's good, perfect. Nok, what is the last one?
Management skill are the abilities that an executive need to be able to perform work in an organization. They include the skill to be the able to managers subordinate.
Yay, very nice. Okay, to be a good manager. Okay, good job. Both of you did well done. Okay, which of the qualities in exercise one do you think each of the photos illustrate? Some could illustrate more than one quality. Okay. So let's look at our photos. Okay, I have to make it very small. Okay, so we can sort of see number one. Which qualities do you think can be one, or it can be more than one, can be two, three? In picture number one, Nok, what do you think that she has?
I think that's an eye for detail.
Yes.
And an outgoing personality.
Do you think she's outgoing? She's just staying, she's not talking to anybody. Maybe an inquiring mind. She wants to know things.
And she's creativity.
Creative. Okay. I think she's looking. She's a scientist or something. Okay. Good. Van Aan, let's look at picture two. I think he's a teacher. Oh, let me make it a bit bigger. There we go. Okay. What kind of personality do you think a teacher should have?
I think it's the
I think that there's a lot there that a teacher should do. Creativity. Okay, it's good.
Yes.
Yes, teachers have to be creative, because if one student doesn't know how to learn the same as another student, then the teacher has to think of a new way to teach the other student.
Yes.
So all the students are different, so you have to teach them differently. Okay, what else do you think to be a teacher, Van Aan?
I think a teacher is creativity, because he has to think
of ways to teach different students.
To teach, he can
different ways to teach.
in different way to teach some pupils.
Okay, what else do you think is very important to be a teacher? Teachers have to
Creativity.
Yes, and what else? They have to
And
talk to students. They have to be very good at talking.
yes.
So what do you think? What is it? From here.
Management skill.
Okay, management skills, but good communication skills is very important.
Yes.
If you are a teacher, okay? Also an outgoing personality. You have to talk to lots of different people. You have to jump. You have to be happy. You can't sit at home and be quiet. Okay. Okay, good. Nock, what do you think about picture three?
I think it's the ability to work in a team.
Yes, definitely. Okay,
And
they look like they're having a good time. They're talking. It looks like they are discussing a project or something, something for the future. They can see the vision.
And a vision.
Vision, yes. Okay. And maybe also outgoing personality because they're all happy to talk to each other. Okay. Or even good communication skills.
Yeah.
Okay. You can tell me all of them, or you can tell me one, or you can tell me seven. Okay. However many you want. Okay. Banan. Number four, I think she's got two. There's two there.
I think she's very creativity.
Yes. Okay. And what else will you give her? She's alone. She's by herself. Okay. So maybe but she's looking into the future as when she's going to finish her project.
Yes.
She has vision.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Sorry, let me just write this quickly. Okay. Good. Knock, what about picture five? Let me go. I'm going to make it a little bit smaller.
I think he is. I think the picture five is creativities and.
And he's dealing with little things. He has to draw detail.
An eyes for detail.
Yes. Okay. Very good. I think that's about all. Creativity and eye for detail. And vision. Okay. He's designing a house. So he has to think about what it will look like at the end. He has to think about the future. So he also has vision. Okay. Okay, Van An, picture number six.
I think they have the
Okay, so let's talk about this man.
This man is very the ability to work in a team and.
Okay, look, he's a lawyer. So a lawyer, they work alone.
Yes.
Okay.
Management skills.
Yes, okay, but this one is very important.
Yes.
Okay, the good communication skills. Okay, he has to be able to talk about anything if you want to be a good lawyer. Okay, lawyer. Okay, and this one also. Outgoing personality. You can't be shy if you are a lawyer. Okay, let's move on. Let's see what they say. Okay, work in pairs. What type of work do you do or want to do and why? Knock, you can start with that question. Okay, you're still in school, so what type of work do you want to do and why? Do you want to be a teacher, a doctor, a lawyer, a dentist?
I want to be a teacher because I can meet many children and I can meet many children and I must create creative and good communication skill to do a teacher.
Yes, okay, yes, very good. Good communication. Well done. Okay. Van An, what about you? What do you want to do?
I wanted to a teacher one day.
To be a
I
teacher?
to be a teacher one day because I can teach a lot of students and have them come clever, become clever, and I can have a creativity.
Creativity, yeah.
And a good community skills.
Yes, good communication skills. Okay, well done. Okay, so now we've answered question number two as well. What other qualities would be useful and why? Okay, Nark, so anything that's not here, what else do you think will be a good teacher?
I think is creativities
But
is the
something, okay, we're going to question number three. Something that is not on this list. It's not there. So you must tell me something different. Okay, so it's not here. It's from, you must tell me something else. To be a good teacher, what do you think will make a good teacher?
To be a good teacher, I think I must be sociabilities and intelligence.
Yes, very good. Social abilities. Okay, good. What about you, Van An? What else do you think a teacher needs to be?
I want to make a good teacher. I have to be serious, focused, and ethical, and have a passion for my work.
Oh, very good. Okay. Did you find something on the internet? I'm happy if you did. That's good. It means you can answer the question. That's fine. As long as you can remember it and study it. Okay. Listening. I don't have the listening. So we're not going to do listening today. Okay. Give me. Let's see. No, we don't have that. Okay, let's talk over here. Work in pairs. Imagine you are talking to another student who you have met at the coffee bar at the graduate fair. Introduce yourselves and tell each other about your... Okay, let me help you over here. Graduate fair. So that means you have finished university. Okay, so now we're just going to act. We are going to pretend and act like we are finished at university. Okay. I understand. So we're just going to act. Okay. So a graduate fair, that's the place, that's like a party when you finish university. So introduce yourself and tell each other. Okay, Nock, you're going to say, hi, my name's Nock. And you're going to tell us about your studies and your qualifications. Okay, or your we won't do current job. Studies and qualifications. So now you're going to tell us what you have studied and why. Do you understand, Nock? So you want to be a teacher? Okay, so like this is a graduate fair. All the people finished university. So you're going to pretend you finished university. Okay, you want to be a teacher. So tell us about how you studied to be a teacher.
To be a teacher, I think I must very intelligent, and I learn well in many in all means subject like science, math, English, and Vietnamese, and to be a teacher, I also focus and sociable in my work.
Okay, good. Now, okay, Bao, Nok, tell me about your career plans and reasons for them. So, what do you plan to do now that you finished studying?
I plan to be a teacher when I finish my studying at the university. And I was very intelligent. It's very difficult for me. So I will try to learn to study hard now to and I hope one day in the future I will be a teacher.
Very good. Okay. Now tell us, okay, Van An. We'll come back to this question. Van An, tell us about your studies and your qualifications. What have you finished now? You also want to be a teacher, so have you finished studying your teaching? How was it? Did you enjoy it? What did you study?
I studied at Vinh Pedagogical School, and my current job is tutoring at home. In my future, I want to be a good teacher because I can teach some people and make them more clever. And in my free time, I often read books to understand more about the subject, and I hope this will come true.
Okay. Okay. Noctilus, tell me about your free time. Good fun, An. What do you do in your free time, and what are your interests?
In my free times, first of all, I always complete my homework before I watch TV or play online game to relax. But I interest to art in my free time.
Do you like painting or do you like drawing?
Yes, I like painting, but my mom tell me that I must complete my homework before I doing things.
Okay, that's good. Then at least it's finished. Okay, well done. Let's go. Now we're going to do some vocabulary. Dependent prepositions. Okay. Complete these extracts from the listening. Okay, we don't have the listening. By writing a preposition in each gap. Sometimes more than one answer is possible. Let me see quickly. Okay, let's do it together. You just have to think of it from your mind. Okay. So we're going to fill in the gaps. What word belongs there? Number one, knock. Can read for me, knock. Obviously.
Obviously, our interest is related the class of degree that you get.
Okay, we always say related to. Related to.
Yes.
Okay, let's try number two.
I haven't actually had any experience in business then.
Yay, very good. Okay, number three.
I want to concentrate to getting my qualification first.
Okay, concentrate on.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, number four is two words.
So when would you be available to be an interview?
To have an interview. Okay. Number five.
I'm quite good at cooking.
Good. Okay, number six.
Have you done any other work in the past that would be relevant?
Relevant.
Relevant to marketing
career. Okay, let me check relevant. Yes. Okay. Number two, choose the correct preposition in italics in each of these sentences. Okay, so you have to choose the right one. You can do number one when you're ready.
The money spent on research was more than expected. Some bosses are not very sensitive to their employees need. The company has a reputation for introducing top quality toys. Producing top quality toys. It is important to have confidence in your own abilities. A lot of students participate on the dog fair. In the dog fair, working parents have little time to take care for their children.
Take care of their children.
Yes.
Well done. Very good. Okay, let's see over here. Okay, often make mistakes with prepositions after adjectives and verbs. Find and correct the mistakes in these sentences by changing or adding a preposition. Okay, to be a leader, you have to compete. Either one can be correct with your colleagues or against your colleagues. Okay, let's try number two. This is smaller. Oops, sorry. Okay, youngsters.
Youngster today are better prepared with working life.
Okay, this one must come out.
A better prepare in working life.
For working life.
For working life.
Okay. Number three.
It is sometimes hard to get involved in your study.
Okay, when you were involved, you're always involved with. Involved with. Okay, number four.
University schools provide students.
Same.
With the facilities they need.
Okay.
But they don't have to be responsible to the staff below them.
Responsible.
In the staff.
For the staff.
The government should pay more attention in the education.
Try again, not in.
For the to the education of women.
Good in my job. Oh, Van Aan, hello. I didn't see you there. Okay, our meeting is going to end now. Okay, let's do this one quickly. In my job, I have to deal with many different types of people. Oh, deal, sorry, I even said it wrong. With. Okay. Let's come back.